to Better Choices TV. I'm Eric.
I'm Malika.
And we have a special guest this week.
Yes, we do.
Danielle Jordan Marshall.
That's my mama gave her that name.
Exactly. We're excited to have Danielle with us.
I'm excited to be here.
Yeah. So, you ready? You want to tell people why we're here?
No, I'm on the side. I'm like, oh man, over here. We're going to bring him in a minute.
Well, the reason why we're here is because, you know, Miss Danielle has a story to tell. You know, it's inspiring. It's motivating.
Absolutely.
It is. You know, I just saw her before pictures, and I've been knowing Danielle for, about 10 years? About that. Yeah, really, huh? We're so young. And it floored me to, you know, go back and to, you know, see her before pictures because, you know, we see this beautiful woman. I mean, she was beautiful then. But, you know, even when we go back, it is just, it's inspiring. It really is, and I was just totally floored to see that baby's picture. I'm still trying to wrap my head around it. But y'all will get to see that. But anyway, we are excited to have you with us today. So let's get started. You know, the first thing that we would like you to share, you know, because I think even for me, you know, I really don't know a lot of your story. It's just tell us, you know, where did it start for you?
I've never been, I guess, a small person.
Yeah. Healthy, that's
right. I guess I've never been healthy. So I guess my weight loss thing is my weight struggle has always been a part of my life. You know, it became more prominent in my 30s. I wasn't exercising. Mm-hmm. So when you're not eating like you should and you're, you know, not exercising like you should, obviously all you're going to do is gain weight.
Right.
So I guess that's been a struggle throughout my life because I've never been an athlete. I've never been one to go take walks. I've never been one to go jogging, go ride my bike. I was an inside kind of kid. You know, that's how my life has always been. But in 2008, I reached a point where I reached, I guess, my peak. Mm-hmm. And it just, something, I guess, clicked for me that it was time for me to make a change.
Was it an incident? What was that moment that, you know, triggered you? Because like with Eric, it was the nurse laughing, you know. So what was that moment?
It was weird. I guess it was kind of like, it was more than one thing. It was several different things that were happening around that
tipping points.
And one would be, I was going on a girls trip to Vegas with my friends. And I remember shopping for this trip, and I remember shopping was just not even fun anymore. It was just like, okay, let me just order some stuff online, whatever it comes in, let's pray it fit, and move on from there.
I have a question for you. Mm-hmm. Up until that point, what were some of the things you had tried, or had you tried, to lose weight?
I had...
Before that point.
Before that point, I guess I had tried to do like, I did try to do Nutrisystem.
Obviously,
it didn't work.
That leads me to my next question, because you said that, and we all had that same problem, that, you know, friends say, well, because she did it to me. That's not my problem, it's your problem.
Yeah.
You know, but now I understand that you have somebody that's doing it with you.
Yeah.
Right? And how's he coming along?
He's coming along good, so he's my pusher. I call him my pusher. He's my Devo. He's my second trainer.
Devo.
Devo. Yes. He keeps me going. He keeps me motivated. He when we're working out, he might take a break on his exercise because he's gonna make sure I'm doing mine.
That's what's up.
So
let me ask you this: was his role just a support role, or did he actually benefit?
He's benefiting from it as well.
It's a combo thing. Both of y'all are doing.
Yes, that's my point.
As a couple.
Yeah.
Being as though you have somebody to do it with and somebody to push you, and not only have somebody, but this being, you know, your significant other, how does that translate over to your relationship?
I think it has brought us closer. We are competitors. Mm-hmm. He is very competitive. We are very competitive together.
Yeah, I heard he always wins.
No, don't believe the hype. Come to the gym.
Uh-oh.
Don't believe the hype, people. I don't care what he posts on Facebook, Instagram.
We're talking about, you know, her transitional moments. So you were talking about Las Vegas and what have you. So was there, you said it was several different things, you know, from the shopping to, you know, not really doing anything. Was it a feeling like just not fitting in or just not being comfortable in your own skin?
I wasn't comfortable in my own skin. I was miserable. Like, because it wasn't me. And, you know, I had never been that large in my life, and I just wasn't in a good space. One of my tipping points was my daughter. My daughter one day saw me with no clothes on, and she said, "Mom." You have three stomachs.
Ooh, wow.
One here. Then she reached over to my back and she said, "One now."
Wow.
And if nothing else will get you
truth,
you know, the truth hurts, but from the mouth of babes, children always tell it just how it is. And when I returned from my trip, somebody posted pictures from the trip and I was like, oh my goodness. You know, like, I saw myself. And that's when I was like, I'm gonna start doing something. So I made an appointment to go see my doctor, because diabetes runs in my family. My mom was a diabetic, or is a diabetic, my dad is a diabetic. So obviously I had gained all this weight, chances are I may be a diabetic. So I went to the doctor, and the doctor at that time told me I was just borderline. I wasn't quite there.
I'll tell you what, we have plenty of other questions that we want to ask you, but we got to take a break. So we'll be right back. I'm going to see if we can get him.
Okay.
Be right back.
So Danielle was telling us about, you know, the turning point. So, you know, it was the Vegas, all of these different things, and, you know, you finally realized that you needed to take control. You know, you needed to change. You know, you needed to change your life. So what did that change look like?
So pulling back from the table, realizing that just because everybody else is eating something, I don't have to eat it. Mm-hmm. You know, I would have friends who would go out, eat, we had a club, they want all the chicken wings.
I'm all in.
I'm down with my girls. You know, I'm down with everybody. You know, so just, I started pulling myself out of some social circles.
You've already said that you changed some of the places you used to eat, some of the foods you used to eat, some of the beverages you used to drink, and now some of the people you even associated with, you're in a circle, right?
I mean, they are still my friends, but I just had to pull away from that, like those interactions.
Right.
You know, I realized a lot of what I was doing, everything was centered around food. Like everything is around food. And that's where my life is just so different there.
Well, and then even having a different mindset about socializing, because you still go out and you'll still have a good time with your friends and stuff, but just appreciating the fact that you're socializing and you're gathering with friends, and it's not about, okay, we're going out and I have to eat, or I have to, you know, feel the pressure of just because they cook, you know, I have to eat what they're serving, or just be in control of what you consume when you're
out. Yeah.
So you mentioned BetterChoices.
Yes.
We love that. So tell us about how has BetterChoices empowered you?
Well, BetterChoices has empowered me before it was even a BetterChoices.
Mm-hmm.
Before
tell
it was a BetterChoices, there was a Malika Bill. And Malika and I have worked together in the past, and she's somebody I know well. And
this is one of your hits.
Because she inspired me. She was another part of my inspiration on my journey, at the beginning of my journey, when her article was featured in Essence.
Well, I have a question. I said I'm going to ask you more questions, but I have a question. All right, now you said Malika inspired you and that got you on your way, and you used that as inspiration and motivation. Now that you've lost the weight and you made the journey yourself, do you find yourself as an inspiration and motivation for other people?
I have, and that's part of the reason why I'm here, because I never realized how my actions could influence somebody else to do better or to look at things differently. It is achievable, You just have to want it and be willing to make the sacrifices and, you know, put yourself above everything else to make it happen. Mm-hmm.
That was
it sounds like you made yourself a priority.
And with you doing that, you didn't lose anything. You know, nothing suffered. Nobody was neglected.
No.
You know, you didn't miss anything. Whatever time you make for you, and you now understand that, that's key, that's golden. And that was one of the things that Eric told me early on, that, you know, unless we make time for ourselves.
What's the point? Yeah. I gotta be here for my baby, I have to be here for my daughter.
Well, what a tremendous experience for the princess to witness, being that, you know, she pointed out, you know, the three stomachs, and she's watched you, you know, make better choices. She's watched you implement activity in your life and do a complete turn, and then see the results, the positive results about those things. So for her to know that anything is possible,
she picks up my weights and she takes my mat and she'll go and say, "I'm doing my exercise," you know. So, and, you know, we take our own walks with us, but she doesn't want to walk like we walk. So, we do our little quarter of a mile. I think the most she's walked with me is probably like a mile and a half.
How many pounds have you lost?
But you know what? How many pounds have you lost?
I lost total about 115 pounds.
Good. Good job. 115 pounds, that's what, 2 third grades?
About that.
Just keep it 100. You know how we do this about 2 third grades.
Yeah.
So that's cool. That's a good job.
So that actually leads us into our next question as far as.
Well, wait. Before we do that, we got to pay the bill. So we're going to take another break. We'll be back with that burning question and the answer on the other end. See y'all in a few minutes. Right into it. We're not gonna BS around, we're not gonna play around, jump right into it, because I've got another question.
What's that?
At your heaviest.
Well, what was the heaviest?
If you don't mind sharing, because
I'm
not sharing.
That's why I'm here. All right.
276
pounds. That's 276. Yeah, so we actually
276.
Share.
276.
Pretty close, because she was 278.
276.
276. So taking 2 pounds back.
All right.
See that?
Right.
I know.
So, how much have you lost?
That's what I'm talking about.
About 115 pounds.
All right, 115. Y'all heard it firsthand from 276, lost 115 pounds. Now, here's the question that they all want to know out there, Better Choices TV Land. How did you do it?
I love to walk. It's my time for me. Mm-hmm. It's my time to think and process stuff. And it's what I do. I love walking. When I don't get to walk, it's when I feel funny. Right. On my days when I don't get to work out, that's when I'm like, you know, the day's not quite right. It's not quite right until I work out. Right.
So you've been going at it for quite some time now, right? For a couple of years?
Mm-hmm. For about 4 years.
All right, so 4 years strong, no excuses. Well, since 2008.
Well, we got to find out how long did it take you to lose the weight?
I've been on my journey, my weight loss journey, since June of 2008. Mm-hmm. June 2008 to October 2009, I lost about 85-90 pounds.
The bulk of the weight.
The bulk of the weight.
That's amazing. So in that, you know, what would, how would you explain how you've been able to maintain what you've lost, plus incorporate, you know, the weight that you've lost and maintaining that as a lifestyle?
Just by continually making better choices.
So you spoke about this this motivation that you have now, this support, the support that you have.
Yeah, because we want to talk about how you stay motivated and how you stay, you know, focused and, you know, what that looks like.
Is somebody trying to ease out of studio?
Yeah, he can see.
I remember a time when we couldn't.
There we go.
All right, so go on and introduce yourself.
How you doing? I'm Ronald, brother, known as Herc.
Debo.
Look, I made it to TV.
So y'all tell us together, you know, how do you stay motivated? How do y'all stay focused on, you know, this journey? And I'm gonna say, you know, it's a new lifestyle. You know,
it is.
There's nothing temporary about it.
And it gets hard sometimes, because sometimes I call Ronald and, you know, I'm calling him at 6:30 because I'm going to go walk before we go to work.
Right.
And he's like,
can I just sleep in late one Saturday, and then sometimes,
yeah, and then sometimes when he get out there, he's booted up.
Right. It's never happy day.
So it sounds like you're more his support than the other way around.
We support each other because when he's out there, he's all changed.
You know,
he just got to get out there.
The people around us are starting to figure out that she's the pusher and I'm the one who's getting pushed.
How many pounds have you lost?
I want to say 40 pounds. Because we right at the same number since we started working out the training, so it's about 40. Our age, so we can say we 41
now. So you good with that 40 pounds, or you still pushing for some more?
It's time to bulk up. You know, I didn't reach the limit, you know.
So you got your comfortable weight?
I'm at my comfortable weight.
And you just want to tone up now?
I want to tone up. You know, but
so if y'all see him out there lifting those steel caps, here come Depot.
No, they'll see you on Facebook pushing up some ties or something like that. I post the pictures.
You know, he's my Instagram.
Yeah. I Instagram a lot of stuff.
Get it in, no excuse.
And he motivates a lot of people.
Yeah, I get to inboxes. What are y'all doing? What are you on? You know, my answer is I'm on fitness. Not no miracle pill, no miracle tea, not no, you know, I went to see a witch doctor. And they helped me, actually getting up and getting in it.
Putting the work in,
hit the floor.
So what you're saying is there's no easy fix, there's no pill to take, there's no magic shake.
No.
How do y'all feel?
I feel great. I feel good. I feel the best that I've ever felt probably in my entire life.
Wow.
Me, myself, I feel high school skinny. You know, for real. It's like, back in the days, you know, when you used to be in high school, you could actually roll out the bed and get up. You hit a long block, you roll out and you get up. When you 40 pounds heavier, you hit alone, you roll over and go back to sleep because you just can't get up. So now I can actually roll over, hit alone, jump up, and I'm off the work, you know.
You know, it's funny you say that about that 40 pounds. This is this thing I keep telling the fellas out there about 35 pounds. And I had to ask y'all, get back to it, this thing that I heard on the Dr. Oz show about, you know, specifically men, when we lose 35 or more pounds, you know, from the midsection, the momentum, that you benefit in other areas. I don't want to put myself out there and say I'm the only one to experience the benefit.
No. It's with the extra 40 pounds, my nickname was Herc. That's H-U-R-E-C. And now that I dropped the 40 pounds, it's Herc. H-U-R-C. Hercules.
So, good luck. You want to comment on that?
Yeah.
I mean, I hate to put you on the spot, but you know I will.
Uh-huh.
I'm getting my Geraldo on.
Tell the ladies what they need to know.
There's plenty of benefits on both sides of the party to lose 40 pounds.
There you go.
Yeah.
You know what? That's a whole different show.
Well, two things. One, to offer, you know, the viewers what you think your top tip would be. And two, what would you say to someone who's struggling and trying to make that decision to make better choices and to, you know, take the steps to change their lives?
My first thing is clean the kitchen. That means get all the unhealthy foods out your house.
Okay.
I mean, because we live in New Orleans, and you know, our top meals is all unhealthy. They're killing people for you. So it's like you have to clean out the bedroom.
Clean house.
Even if you have kids, I mean, it's the perfect time to put everybody on.
Yeah, because then they're going to learn some valuable habits.
Well, it's a team. Everybody's got to be all in. And I think you mentioned that earlier when you were saying about, you know, your friends and having to struggle with, you know, you being on the health side of it and then being in an environment that, you know, was not conducive or matching up to your goals. So what was the tip that you would offer?
I would say it's hard to narrow it down, but I would say identify three bad habits, you know, eating habits that you know you have, and try to, you know, change it or eliminate it. Definitely, I would encourage you to add water
yes.
to your diet.
Hydration.
And thirdly, I would say just get up and move.
Get going.
Do something.
That was
wonderful.
Follow Better Choices.
Thank you again. Thank you, Danielle.
Thank
wonderful
you.
Job. Thank you, Ron.
Thank
wonderful
you,
job.
I
appreciate it.
Thank you.
Pleasure.
So that's it. That's going to wrap it up for this week. We had, like I said, two very special guests, and I'm glad Ron decided to join us, because before he was like, nah, I'm standing aside.
Stand back.
But you know what? His story may motivate want somebody out there to change too. So.
Yeah. But we know it will.
It will.
Because it's already doing that. It's
yeah.
already doing it.
Couples.
Yeah.
Y'all see a pattern.
Like,
there it is.
Yeah. You get it in.
Find your partner.
There you go. No, you got a partner. He or she is sitting right next to you. Both of y'all get up and get active. We'll holler at y'all next week.